exploring patterns. A pattern consists of a set of numbers or shapes that appear from one term to another according to a specific rule. If we know the rule of a pattern or sequence, we can complete the pattern or extend it and find the missing term easily. So in pattern or finding the pattern, so it depends on the pattern that we are solving. So not unlike in finding the sum, difference, product, or quotient, or the volume of this kind of shape, the area, the perimeter. So we have the formula. But in pattern, it depends on the given numbers or shape that we are solving. So we have rule here in finding the pattern. But the rule is to be critical thinker, to be creative, and to be more observable. So dahil sa ating pattern, it's not like that we have the formula na gagamitin natin to find the pattern. So dapat maging critical thinker tayo, maging creative tayo on how we are going to solve this kind of problem. So we have two types of pattern that we are going to learn in this video. So the first one is the geometric pattern and the second one is the number pattern. So in geometric pattern, it is more about shapes and figures. So let me give you example. So I have here the first term of first five term geometric shapes. So first term natin, so bawat isang numbers or shape natin, it is called a term. So first term, second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term, and so on. So here the first five term. Yung first five term ko ay square, circle, and triangle, then followed by square and circle. So if I'm going to ask you, what would be the sixth term? Ano kaya yung sixth term natin? Pang-anim na term natin. So, para mahanap natin yung sixth term, we need to be observable dun sa ating given terms and shapes natin. So, if you notice, the first term is circle and followed by, the first term is square followed by circle. And the circle is followed by triangle. So, ito yung pagkakasunod-sunod niya. And then, after the triangle, it goes back to square. So, naging square ulit siya. Then, followed by circle. So, yung arrangement niya ay katulad dito sa ating first three term. So, yung fourth term ay square and fifth term ay circle. So, if dito ang next ng circle ay triangle, what would be the sixth term? So, the sixth term is triangle. So, very good dun sa ating mga nakakuha. Next natin is, if I'm going to ask you what would be the seventh term, so that would be square. So, dahil after ng triangle natin ay square. Next natin is eighth term natin ay circle. Ninth term natin ay triangle. So, if you observe, ang pagkakasunod-sunod niya, square, circle, triangle, then square, circle, triangle, and then square, circle, and triangle. So, tinatawag natin pattern. So, titignan lang natin how the shape arranged. So, meron pa tayong another example, and this is a part of the exercises. So, pwede kayo mag-prepare ng paper. Here the first five term. Yung first term ko ay plus, second term ko ay minus, third term ko ay times, fourth term ko ay division or divide, and fifth term ko ay equal. So if I ask you what would be the sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth term, ano kaya siya? Ano kaya yung sixth to tenth term natin? So para masagutan niyo siya, pwede niyo i-post ng video para magkaroon tayo ng time to answer the sixth to tenth term. If you are done, we can check your answer. So, listen carefully sa ating answer. So, yung sixth term natin ay plus, second term natin ay minus. Yung 8th term natin ay times. Yung 9th term natin ay divide. And yung 10th term natin ay equal. So, ganito lang po yung pag analyze ng ating geometric figures. So, now let's move on to our number pattern. Number pattern. A pattern consists of a set of numbers, then it is called a number pattern. So, look at the following number pattern or sequence below. So, ito po yung ating number pattern. So, we have the first 5 term, which is 2, 5, 8, 11, and 14. So, paano ba ito nakuha? So, let's analyze paano natin nakuha ito. First, we can see the pattern consists of numbers in increasing order. So, kung makikita nyo, pataas yung number natin from first term to fifth term. So, therefore, the following pattern or the term, which is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, dapat mas mataas din siya sa 14 and increasing order din siya. We can see that the difference of the two consecutive term is 3. So, yung first two consecutive term natin ay, ang difference niya ay 3. So, paano po ba siya? If we're going to subtract 2, and 5, it is equal to 3. So, 5 minus 2 is 3. And then, next natin is, if we're, again, always see the difference of 2 consecutive. Pero, hindi siya laging 2 consecutive. So, eto lang yung pinaka-basic natin muna na pag-aaralan. So, if we're going to subtract or to find the difference of these 2 terms, 2 consecutive, it means magkasunod. So, 8 minus 5 is 3. Then, yung third and fourth term natin. So, if 11 minus 8 is equal to 3. And then, 14 minus 11 is equal to 3. So, kung makikita nyo, yung difference ng bawat term ay 3. So, therefore, nakuha itong 5... Dahil 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. And then, nakuha yung third term natin. Dahil 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. At nakuha naman yung fourth term natin. Dahil 8 plus 3 is 11. And then, nakuha yung fifth term natin. Dahil 11 plus 3 is equal to 14. So, ganun lang yung pagkuha ng term niya dito sa ating problem na to. Ating sequence na given ngayon. So, if I'm going to ask, what would be the sixth term? Okay, so sixth term natin, seventh term, eighth term, ninth term, and tenth term. So, paano ba natin makukuha? So, kung bawat term nag-a-add tayo ng 3, therefore, yung fifth term natin is... We're going to add 14 plus 3, it is equal to 17. So, 17 yung ating 6th term. So, if we're going to find the 7th term, so, ang gagawin lang natin dito ay plus 3. So, therefore, 17 plus 3 is equal to 20. So, therefore, the 7th term natin ay 20. If we're going to find the 8th term, so 20 plus 3 is equal to 23. So, ang 8th term natin ay 23. And then, 23 plus 3 is equal to 26. And then, 26 plus 3 is equal to 29. So, if we are going to find the 11 up to 20 term, ang gagawin lang natin ay magpa-plus 3 lang tayo na magpa-plus 3. Dahil, ito yung ating pattern. So, to get the term, we have the pattern na i-add natin yung 3 sa bawat term to get the next ng ating number pattern ay magpa-plus 3 lang tayo sa lahat ng term, magpa-plus 2, or magpa-plus 5, and so on. Sometimes, iba-iba din siya. So, before that, we have the number pattern. So, kung makikita natin dito, we have 2, 5, 8, 11, and 14. At pag may nakita tayong 3 dots, ayan. So, 3 dots means the sequence goes on infinitely. Pag sinabi natin infinitely, walang katapusan. So, magko-continue siya hanggang kahit hanggang saan. So, kahit umabot pa yan ng 1,000, million, billion, and so on. So, let me give you an example. So, find the missing term in sequence. So, here, the first term is 30, second term is 28, third term is missing, and fourth term is 24, and fifth term is 22. So, paano ba natin mahahanap yung missing term natin, which is yung third term natin? So, we need to analyze the first and second term, and also the fourth and fifth term. So, how can we be sure if we are going to subtract 2? Kasi, if you are going to subtract 2, which is 30 minus 2 is equal to 28, paano natin masusure if this is subtract 2 din? So, kailangan maging minus 2 din ito. So, 24 minus 22 is 2. So, therefore, 24 minus 2 is equal to 22. So, dahil pareha siyang minus 2, yan, dahil pareha siyang minus 2, so, ang gagawin lang din natin to get the third term, we will subtract 28 minus 2 is equal to 26. So, we can see that the pattern consists of number in decreasing order. So, pababa. So, it means, alin lang kasi sa dalawa. Pag increasing, mag-a-add tayo. Pag decreasing, magsasubtract tayo. So, we can see that the difference between the first two terms is 2. So, that is 30 minus 28 is equal to 2. And we also find that the difference between each number and the number it follows is 2. So, therefore, the third term is 26. So, what if we're going to find the 6th and 10th term? So, since dito minus 2 lang tayo, so therefore, yung 5th term natin ay minus 2. So, to get the 6th term. So, 22 minus 2 is equal to 20. So, ang ating 6th term ay 20. And then, i-check natin paano nakuha itong 7th term, we will subtract 20 minus 2, it is equal to 18. So, tama po siya. And then, to check the 8th term, so, 18 minus 2 is equal to 16. And then, to check the 9th term, so, 16 minus 2 is equal to 14. Then, yung 10th term natin ay missing. So, anong gagawin natin? We are going to subtract the 9th term. So, 14 minus 2 is equal to 12. So, yung example natin kanina, nagpa-plus 3 tayo to get the next term. So, dito, nag-subtract tayo ng 2 to get the missing term or the next term. So, let me give you another example. So, find the next term in sequence. So, I have here the first to 10th term. So, yung 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th term natin ay missing. So, ngayon, paano natin kaya makukuha yung missing? So, if we are going to subtract these first two terms, ang difference niya ay 2. So, if you are going to 2 plus 2, or you're going to add this, it is equal to 4. And then, the difference of these two terms is also 2. So, dahil 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. But, make sure na magpa-plus 2 lang tayo na magpa-plus 2 if the difference of this each 2 term is equal to 2. Basta yung difference dapat nila lahat ay 2. Pag lahat ay 2, ibig sabihin, magpa-plus 2 lang tayo. Pero katulad nito, the difference of this 2 term, which is 10 minus 4, 10 minus 6 is equal to 4, which is hindi siya 2. Yan. Katulad niyan. Ito 2, ito 2 rin, ito ay 4. So, ibig sabihin, hindi lang tayo pwedeng mag-plus 2 ng mag-plus 2 dahil meron tayong 4. Okay. Next natin is the difference of 16 and 10. So, the difference is 6. So, iba ulit siya. And then, the difference of 5th and 6th term is 10. So, yung difference niya ay 10. So, iba ulit. So, ibig sabihin, hindi natin makukuha yung 7th term pag nag-plus 2 tayo. So, hindi siya tama. So, ano yung gagawin natin? So, we need to find another way kung paano natin siya masosolve. So, hindi siya pwedeng plus 2 lang ng plus 2. So, let's think another way. Kung hindi tayo pwedeng mag-plus 2 ng mag-plus 2, what if... ipag-plus natin to first 2 term. So, let's say 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. Equal siya ng ating third term. Right? So, 6 yung sagot. What if we are going to add this 2 term? So, 4 plus 6 is equal to 10. So, yun yung fourth term natin. And the next naman natin is get the fifth term. We're going to add the third and fourth term. So, 10 plus 6 is equal to 16. So, ipag-a-add natin. So, yun yung sagot natin sa fifth term. So, ngayon, nakukuha na natin how to get the term. So, if we continue this, if we will add this fourth and fifth term, so 10 plus 16 is equal to 26. So, yun yung sixth term natin. So, since nakukuha na natin yung pattern, paano isolve yung mga term natin, so, ngayon, nahahanap na natin kung ano yung ating seventh term. So, to find the seventh term, we need to add the fifth and sixth term. So, if we are going to add the 16 plus 26, so 16 plus 26 is equal to 42. So, yun yung ating 7th term, 42. And to find the 8th term, we need to add 6th and 7th term. So, ipag-a-add lang natin siya. So, 26 plus 42 is 68. So, yun yung ating 8th term. And then, the 9th term is, we need to add this 2 term. So, 42 plus 68 is equal to 110. So, yun yung ating 9th term. And to find the 10th term, we need to add this 8th and 9th term. So, 68 plus 110 is equal to 178. So, ganun lang po yung pagkuha ng ating missing term or next term sa ganitong problem. So, it depends sa ating problem kung paano natin makukuha yung mga term. So, if I ask you what would be the 11th term, so, ipag-a-add lang natin itong 9th and 10th term. So, 110 plus 178 is equal to 200. So, yung 11th term natin ay, so, let's say 11th term yan. So, 288. So, therefore, yung ating 11th term ay 288. So, if you're going to find what is the 12th term, so, ipag-a-add nyo lang din to. So, yun yung ating pattern dito sa ating sequence dito. So, let me give you another example. So, find the next term in sequence. So, hanapin natin yung pattern dito. So, like what I said, na yung to find the pattern for the next term, the pattern, the rule is depend on the pattern that we are solving. So, depende siya sa sinosolve natin. Kailangan maging creative tayo. So, let's try to find the difference of this. These two terms, para mahanap natin 7, 8, 9, and 10 term. So, the difference of these two term is 1. The difference of these two term is 2. So, magkaiba siya. So, hindi pwedeng magpa-plus 1 lang tayo ng magpa-plus 1 dahil hindi tama. Hindi rin naman pwedeng magpa-plus 2 tayo ng magpa-plus 2 dahil hindi rin magiging tama yung sagot natin dito. So, if you are going to find the difference of this, so 3, yan, 5, minus 2 is 3. The next natin is 2, 7 minus 2 is 5. Yan. So, magkakaiba siya. So, ito ay, hindi na siya magkakapareho. So, magkakaiba na siya. So, we need to find another way. So, another way of solving and finding the next term. So, if we're going to add, katulad ng ginawa natin. So, if we're going to add this, magiging 5, which is, again, i-add natin itong first two term, ang sagot niya ay third term. I-add naman natin to, sagot niya ay dapat 8. But then, this is not 8. 2. Ano kaya yung pwede natin gawin? Or ano pa yung possible na answer? So, kung i-add ko to, sagot niya ay third term. Kung i-add ko naman to, hindi naman siya magiging sagot ng fourth term. What if gagawin kong minus 2 itong second and third term. So, let's try. If we are going to subtract the second and third term, ang sagot natin ay, so 5 minus 3 is 2. So, ang sagot niya ay yung fourth term. So, tama na siya. So, if I'm going to subtract this, sagot niya ay dapat 3. But then, ang sagot niya ay 7. So, ano kaya yung pwede kong gawin dito sa sa third and fourth term para maging sagot niya ay 7? So, instead of subtracting, plus. So, 5 plus 2 is 7. So, to find the next term, I will add this. So, if i-add ko yung 2 and 7, it is equal to 9. So, hindi siya sagot na 6th term. Dapat 5 yung sagot. So, ano yung gagawin ko? So, instead of add, sasubtract siya. So, 7 minus 2 is 5. So, yun yung sagot ng ating 6th term. Yan. So, if you notice, the pattern, ang gagawin ay add, then subtract, then add, then subtract. Yan. Add, then subtract. So, add, subtract, add, subtract, then kung nag-subtract ako dito, ano yung next operation na gagamitin ko dun sa next two term? So, of course, dapat plus. So, dapat ipag-a-add ko to. So, therefore, 7 plus 5 is equal to 12. So, nakuha na natin yung 7th term natin, which is 12. So, what would be the operation to this term, or this two term, para makuha yung 8th term. So, kung makikita natin, tapos na tayo sa add. So, alternate siya, di ba? So, next natin ay subtract. So, if we are going to subtract 12 minus 5, it is equal to 7. So, nag-subtract tayo, ang sagot niya ay 7 to get the 8th term. And to find the 9th term, gagawin naman natin dito ay mag-plus dahil alternate. So, after nag-subtract, magpa-plus tayo. So, 12 plus 7 is equal to 19. So, yun na yung ating 9th term. And to get the 10th term, so we are going to subtract this to a term. So, 19 minus 7 is equal to 12. So, yun na yung ating 10th term. So, to find the 11th term, so yung 11th term yung hahanapin natin. So, anong gagawin natin dito? Anong operation naman kaya? So, this is plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Then, dito ay plus naman. So, 19 plus 12 is equal to 31. So, therefore, the 11th term is equal to 31. So, to find the 12th term, ang gagawin naman natin dito ay subtract. So, eto ngayon yung rule natin dito sa problem na to. So, diba? Kung nakikita nyo yung differences niya, and then, depends talaga siya sa ating problem. So, yung una natin, nagpa-plus 3 tayo. Yung pangalawang example natin, nagsasubtract 2 tayo. Next naman, yung next example naman natin, ang ginagawa natin kanina ay, nag-add lang natin yung bawat term. And then, dito naman is, alternate. Nag-add tayo, then subtract, then add, subtract. So, we need to be creative. So, marami pang problems na different way naman siya sinusolve. So, let's have an example. So, find the next term in sequence. So, ayan. So, iba na siya sa example natin kanina. So, yung first to 10th term natin. So, 7 to 10th term, hahanapin natin siya. So, we need to think ano kaya yung pattern nito. Paano kaya nakuha? So, let's see. If we are going to add this, 5 ang sagot. So, yun yung sagot natin sa 3rd term. So, plus natin siya. If we are going to add this, ang sagot naman natin ay 8. Ito din yung sagot niya. So, add lang siya. And if we are going to add this 3rd and 4th term, so 5 plus 8 is equal to 13. So, since 13, pero 12 yung sagot natin dito, so hindi siya pwedeng add lang tayo ng add. So, let's think another way. So, let's replace this. So, paano kaya if we are going to find the difference? So, the difference of this is, so 3 minus 2 is 1. So, ang sagot niya 1. So, the difference of this is, so 5 minus 3 is 2. Next difference natin ay, so 8 minus 5 is 3. So, magkakaiba siya. So, next natin ay 12 minus 8 is 4. Pero kung nakikita nyo, sunod-sunod siya. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then, if we are going to subtract 12 and 17, ang sagot natin ay 5. So, ano kayang ibig sabihin ito? So, nakuha ba yung second term dahil nag 2 plus 1 ako? 3. So, mag-a-add ako ng pataas din. So, therefore, yung second term natin, nag-add ako ng 2, which is equal to 5. And then, yung 5, nag-add ako ng 3, is equal to 8. And 8, nag-add ako ng 4, it is equal to 12. So, therefore, if I'm going to add, so yung next ng 4 natin ay 5, so, nag-add ako ng 5 sa 12, it is equal to 17. So, to get the 7th term, ano kaya yung i-add ko? So, kung nakikita natin yung pattern, ha? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, then this is 5. So, dito, mag-a-add ako ng 6. So, pag nag-add ako ng 6, ang sagot natin ngayon sa 7th term ay 23. So, ang pattern natin dito, mag-a-add tayo, pero in ascending order. Hindi lang tayo pwedeng mag-add lang ng 1, tapos tapos plus 1 lang din dito, plus 1 lang din sa third term, plus 1 lang din sa fourth term, pero meron tayo sinusunod na standing order, which is dito 1, dito mag-a-add ako ng 2, dito mag-a-add ako ng 3, mag-a-add ako ng 4, dito mag-a-add ako ng 5, dito mag-a-add ako ng 6. So kung dito nag-add ako ng 6, ilan naman kaya yung i-add ko dito to get the 8th term? So, after ng 6 natin is 7. If we're going to add 23 plus 7, it is equal to 30. So, nakukuha na natin yung pattern natin. So, mag-a-add lang pala ako ng 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in each term. So, to get the 9th term, ang i-add ko naman dito ay magpa-plus ako ng, tapos na tayo sa 7, so therefore, it is 8. So, 30 plus 8 is equal to 38. So, nakukuha na natin. And then, next natin is to find the 10th term. If dito nag-add ako ng 8, dito ilan naman kaya yung i-add ko? So, dito i-add ko ay 9. So, therefore, 38 plus 9 is equal to 47. So, paano ko kukunin ko yung 11th term? So, 11th term. Ano gagawin ko? Ilan yung i-add ko dito? Kung dito nag-add ako ng 9, dito ilan yung i-add ko? 10. Very good. So, therefore, 47 plus 10 is equal to 57. So, ang ating 11th term ay 57. Let me give you another example, pero ibang situation naman. So, find the next two terms. So, hahanapin natin yung fourth and fifth term. So, titignan natin yung possible na way paano natin nakukuha yung term. So, kung isasubtract natin yung 36 and 12, ang sagot niya ay 24. And, kung isasubtract ko naman to, ang sagot niya ay 72. Let's say 72 yan. So, hindi siya equal. And then, think, ano pa yung another way para makuha tong second term? So, ano kaya yung pwede kong gawin sa first term para makuha yung second term? So, aside sa pag-a-add or sa pagsasubtract, pwede rin ako mag-multiply. So, ano kaya yung pwede kong i-multiply sa 12 para maging 36? So, that is 3. If I'm going to multiply 12 sa 3, then it is equal to 36. So, kaya nakuha natin yung a second term. So, ayan. So, we notice that the pattern consists of numbers in increasing order. So, therefore, paano ba tayo ano ba yung mga way para mag-increase tayo? First is mag-a-add tayo. Second is mag-multiply tayo. Dahil pag nag-multiply tayo, tumataas yung ating number. So, we can see that the difference of the first two terms, which is 36 and 12, is 24. And 108 and 36 is 72. Which 24 and 72 is not equal. Therefore, we must find another pattern or way on how we are going to find the next term in the sequence. So, ito na yung another way natin. Magmumultiply tayo. So, if we're going to multiply 12 times 3, ang sagot niya ay 36, which is ang ating second term. So, kung nag-multiply tayo dito, why don't we try if nag-multiply tayo ng 3 dito, ang sagot niya ay 108. So, let's try. So, 36 times 3 is equal to 108. So, therefore, the third term is 108. So, ang ating pattern ay hindi tayo mag-a-add, hindi rin tayo magsasubtract, but we are multiplying each term by 3. So, kung eto minultiply natin by 3, so, to find the fourth term, so ayan, to find the fourth term, we will multiply 108 for the third term by 3. So 108 times 3 is equal to 324. So therefore, this is the fourth term. The fifth term, so yung fifth term. So para mahanap natin yung fifth term, so magmumultiply tayo dito ng 3. So 324 times 3 is equal to 972. Therefore, it is the fifth term. So, paano ngayon kung maghahanap ako ng sixth term? Anong gagawin ko sa 972? So, magmumultiply lang din ako na times 3. So, therefore, the sixth term is, so 972 times 3 is equal to 2,916. So therefore, the sixth term is 2,916. So ganun lang po yung pag-solve nito. So next nating example is to find the next three term. So I have here the first term, second term, third term. Then the fourth to sixth term is missing. So paano kaya natin siya mahahanap? So, if you notice, this is decreasing order. So, from 2,000 naging 700. 2,187 naging 729. Then, naging 243. So, decreasing siya. So, sa decreasing natin, it's either magsasubtract tayo each term or magdi-divide tayo. So, if we are going to subtract this, so 2,000, 187 minus 700 minus 729 is equal to 1,000 let's see 1,458. So ito yung difference nila. So kung magsasubtract ako ng 1,458 dito sa ating first term, ang sagot niya ay 729. And then this one is, so 729 minus natin sa 243, it is equal to 486. So magkaiba siya. So let's try another way. So kung hindi tayo pwede sa subtract, why don't we try to divide? So ano kaya yung pwede nating i-divide sa 2,187 para makuha natin yung 729? So, pwede nating i-divide itong dalawa. So, kung i-divide natin yung 2,187 divided by 729, it is equal to 3. So, therefore, if we will divide this 2,187 sa 3, ang sagot niya ay 729. So, let's try this pattern. Let's try to divide this 729 sa 3. So, 729 divided by 3 is equal to 243. So, therefore, ang pattern natin ay i-divide lang natin bawat term sa 3. So, nakukuha na natin yung pattern. If we now get the pattern, now we can answer the 4th, 5th, and 6th. So, anong gagawin lang natin? Magdi-divide lang tayo ng 3. So, yung 3rd term, i-divide lang natin sa 3. So, 243 divided by 3 is 81. So, ang ating 4th term ay 81. And then, to get the 5th term, i-divide lang tayo ng 3 sa ating 4th term. So, 81 divided by 3 is equal to 27. So, ang ating 5th term ay 27. And then, to get the 6th term, so, we need to divide 27 divided by 3. 27 divided by 3 is equal to 9. So, if I ask you, the seventh term. So, ang gagawin lang natin sa sixth term ay, i-divide lang natin siya sa 3. So, 9 divided by 3 is equal to 3. So, therefore, ang seventh term natin ay 3. So, ayan yung mga different examples natin in different way on how we are going to find this sequence. So, maraming way and this pattern, hindi siya nagre-require ng any formulas or any formulas na kailangan yung memorizing. But, it needed the creativity and critical thinker para ma-solve itong pattern na ito.